Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Hiral Patel, an assistant professor in English working at the KNSB Arts and Commerce College, Kerala. Today, I'm going to talk about humanism. It has been prescribed in the syllabus of BSN2 Special English, paper CP202. Humanism was a major intellectual movement of the Renaissance. So basically, it was a part and parcel of Renaissance movement. As a Renaissance movement, humanism was a revival of the study of the classics, a revival of the classical learning. It began in the late 14th century in Italy and came into maturity in the 15th century and spread to the rest part of the Europe after the middle of the 15th century. Humanism then became the dominant intellectual movement in Europe in 16th century. Under the influence and inspiration of the classics, humanists developed a new learning. Humanism articulated new moral perspectives and values, offering guidance in life, how to live in life. Humanism is a philosophical stance that emphasizes the value of human being. Human being is in the center in this philosophy. It affirms faith in self-fulfillment. So basically, it is a movement revolving around human beings, their value. Humanism teaches us that it is immoral to wait for God to act for us. We must act to stop the wars and the crimes and the brutality of this and future ages. We, human beings, have powers of a remarkable kind. We, human beings, have a high degree of freedom in choosing what we will do. Humanism tells us that whatever our philosophy of the universe may be, ultimately the responsibility for the kind of world in which we live rests with us, means with the human being. Politically, the defiance of religious and secular authority has led to democracy, human rights, and the protection of the environment. So, this can be called the outcomes or consequences of humanism. Humanism is one of those philosophies for people who think for themselves. There is no area of thought that a humanist is afraid to challenge and explore. So, humanists explore and challenge each and every area of thought. Humanists make no claims to possess or have access to supposed transcendent knowledge. Humanism is a philosophy of reason and science. In the pursuit of knowledge, humanists reject arbitrary faith. Humanism is a philosophy of imagination. Because humanists recognize that intuitive feelings, flashes of inspiration, imagination, emotion are useful sources of ideas that can lead us to new ways of looking at the world. These ideas can be applied for solving problems of human life. Humanism is a philosophy for here and now, present time. Humanists regard human values as making sense only in the context of human life rather than in the promise of a supposed life after death. So present life is important, not the future life. You cannot or you should not sacrifice your present life for a better future life. So you should concentrate on making your present life better and more beautiful. That is the basic concept here. Humanism is a philosophy of compassion towards others, towards other human beings. Humanist ethics is solely concerned with meeting human needs and answering human problems. for both the individual and society. So the basic concept is to fulfill the requirements, human needs, and to solve human problems. Humanism is a realistic philosophy. Humanists recognize the existence of moral dilemmas and the need for careful consideration of immediate and future consequences in moral decision making. Humanism is in tune with the science of today. Because humanists recognize that we live in a natural universe of great size and age, that we evolved on this planet over a long period of time. So basically they seem to be affirming the evolution theory, the scientific theory. Humanism is in tune also with today's enlightened social forces. Because humanists are committed to civil liberties, human rights, church and state separation, democracy not only in government but in the workplace and education, and expansion of global consciousness and exchange of products and ideas internationally, and an open-ended approach to solving social problems, an approach that follows for the testing of new alternatives. All these concepts, they suggest today's enlightened modern social thought, and the same were characterized by humanists when they began also. When they began this movement, at that time also they used to apply this theory. Humanism is in tune with new technological developments also, because humanists are willing to take part in emerging scientific and technological discoveries, because that is the main concept of humanism, how human skills can be developed more and more for making human life better and better. Humanism is, in sum, in total, a philosophy for those who are in love with life. Humanists take responsibility for their own life and relish the adventure of being part of new discoveries, seeking new knowledge, and exploring new options. For what? For human beings. For making human life better. Humanism is a rational philosophy, informed by science, inspired by art, and motivated by compassion. It affirms the dignity of each human being. It affirms the importance, the significance of each human being. It supports the maximization of individual liberty, freedom and opportunity. It recognizes human beings as a part of nature and holds that values, whether they are religious values, ethical values, social values or political values, they all values have their source in human experience and culture. Humanism thus derives the goals of life from human need and interest, rather than from theological or ideological abstraction, and asserts that humanity must take responsibility for its own destiny. Human beings themselves can change or affect their own destiny. They themselves must try to change their life. Thank you. Thank you very much.